Go ahead, John, 2 minutes.
BJ, thanks for the opportunity. This is forum 2560 that we've done, and so I can assure you that if you've got a tough question that probably I haven't gotten, and the reality is bring it, that's okay. Thank you for the opportunity to be here this evening. My name is indeed John Watson. I'm a candidate for chairman of the Georgia Republican Party. For the past 25 years, since a kid in the 1980s that lived and saw Ronald Reagan and had a bad haircut to show it, I think some of the young folks see on the internet, but nonetheless, began a career 25 years ago working on behalf of the party that I love. I was finance director to Congressman Bob Barr in 1994, finance director for Chairman Rusty Paul at the Georgia Republican Party, so I've been an employee of the party. Best part about that process was that I met my wife Kimberly. 20 years will be December will be 20 years, and 16-year and 14-year-old girls have been a wonderful experience on our behalf. Life got very, very interesting for my career when I met a middle Georgia senator by the name of Sonny at that point in time. And so I had the opportunity and was the chief political consultant to then Sonny Perdue. We obviously, along with many, many of the men and women in this room, changed Georgia history, as Mr. Galloway will tell us, and broke the 135-year drought that created a Republican majority and a Republican governor. I later went on to serve as his chief of staff, had the opportunity to see him safely through re-election, and an honor of serving and working on behalf of the great state of Georgia. Last thing of opportunity from a bio standpoint, I will simply say that I had the high honor of being the campaign co-chair for David Perdue, and certainly appreciate all that he's doing, and again, men and women throughout this room that came together after a hard-fought process to get behind David, and thank you for those efforts. I am running, ladies and gentlemen, because the party that I love and the party that you all love is in trouble. We are at a crossroads. We are at least $300,000 in debt.
I'll let you finish your sentence. Is it your turn? Okay.
Yeah, that was my bad.
All right. Judy's taking phone calls. We brought in IT support. You ready?
Ready.
Michael Welch.
Good evening. How are y'all tonight? It's a real pleasure to be back in this area. I grew up not too far from here over in DeKalb County where I went to high school. I was born up in North Georgia. And when I graduated from high school, I went to UGA like most everybody in my class, picked up a bachelor's degree in finance, and my lovely bride, Susie, who's with me tonight. I do have a big favor, though. Y'all need to pray for me. Our 35th wedding anniversary is the Monday after the convention, and you can imagine how much planning I've done for that. So help me out on that. Anyway, I have four kids, two that are married and have children of their own, and then two that are still at home, a 19-year-old daughter, Grace, who was a 2016 Teenage Republican of the Year, and this summer will be interning. She flies out Wednesday, to intern for Senator David Perdue up in D.C. And then 17-year-old son, Samuel, who's my little guy, he's 6'5", and he is the current second vice chair for the Teenage Republicans. I am the state advisor for the Teenage Republicans, and I just finished a stint as the 12th district chairman, where as that chairman, we were able to knock off and muster the resources we needed to eliminate the last blue dog Democrat in the South, John Barrow, and put Rick Allen in place. So we took the last, a great seat there, and we were able to do that. And I'm running tonight because I have a plan, and hopefully I'll get to spend a little more time about it. It's on my push card. There are 4 points on my plan to be able to fix the issues that face the party and prepare us for the future. And I humbly and honestly wish for your vote, your support in Augusta in June. Thank you.
Well, good evening, everyone. My name is Michael McNeely, and I'm asking for your vote to become the next chairman of the Georgia Republican Party. A little bit about me. I grew up in Renz, Georgia, a little rural town near Augusta, Georgia. Grew up in the home of Alec and Francis McNeely, who at 9 months old adopted me, so the right to life issue is very important to me. Everything about my life has been focused on God and country. I was in the Boy Scouts and the Proud Eagle Scout. served in the Georgia Army National Guard, was a police officer for 14 years, and currently an executive with Georgia Juvenile Justice. In the party, I worked my way up through the ranks, first volunteering for the re-election campaign of Governor Sonny Perdue. Went to my county, helped get Republicans elected, and grow our party by doing the things that we all do, waving signs, making phone calls, and going door to door. I was vice chair, third and first vice chair in my county, served as the political director for the Georgia Young Republicans, served as the Georgia Black Republican Council chair, and now is first vice chair of the Georgia Republican Party. Everything about what we do in our party is about service, and I'm here to serve. We've got a lot that we can do. We've got a lot that's broken that must be fixed. But there's a world out there, a lot of people, a lot of families around the state that want to hear from us, and we have to be able to message our conservative principles and how they apply to people. We have to grow our party with people that aren't with us today, but could be, if we unite as our grassroots, if we work together in all 159 counties. And I look forward to doing that with you in a new role, hopefully. But either way, I'm going to be Michael McNeely. I'm going to be a conservative. And I think that we've got a lot of great things we can do, and I look forward to that.
Hey everyone, for those of you who don't know me, I'm Alex Johnson. I'm running for chairman of the state GOP. I live in Dunwoody, Georgia, North DeKalb County, with my wife, Andrea. I've been involved in the party for a pretty long time. I first got involved in the College Republicans at Oglethorpe University way back in 2004, where I helped refound them. 2009, I got involved in the DeKalb Republican Party. 2010, ran for state senate in DeKalb against the Democrat. Was chairman of the DeKalb Young Republicans a couple times. I'm legal counsel in the DeKalb County Republican Party. And I've run for chairman of the state Republican Party two other times, once with BJ, and then another time 2 years ago. I've always been about the idea that the party needs to be focused on the grassroots. My private job has nothing to do with politics. I'm a self-employed attorney. I'm 32 years old. I practice litigation. I do civil rights litigation, personal injury, some civil rights, and some random cases. But that's what I do. And I spend my time, devote my time regarding the Republican Party because I believe in the truth of the Republican Party's principles. I believe that the party and what we stand for, family values, pro-life, limited government, that those things are good for society. And what we need to be doing is advocating those principles to make sure they get enacted into law so people want to be involved with us. We need to be empowering the grassroots and showing them how to be involved. And I've been doing that for the past 4 years. First with Advance the GOP and the newsletters that many of you may have received to tell you about events and what's going on in politics. And about a year, year and a half ago, I became president of the Georgia Republican Assembly, which is a Republican group that is devoted to getting principled people into office. And like I started with about 6 members statewide, now we have about over 170 paid members. So I've been working to try to get more people involved, even when the party's been in debt and it hasn't been going too well at the state level. And I'm committed to doing that as chairman of the state Republican Party. Well, everyone, thank you for having me here today. I think the most important thing to be looking at in the chairman's race, especially since this is politics, is looking at credibility, looking at results. If you look back, I've been saying for the past, but at least starting 4 years ago, we need to focus on the grassroots. We need to get more people involved in the party. We need more people to know how to have an impact. We need people to know, for example, that resolutions are official statements of what the party and the activists believe in. We need people to know how to run for office, how to run for party office, how to be in touch with legislators, how to actually make an impact and make a difference in politics. Because I think that's probably why all of us have gotten involved. And we need more people to be involved that you can lead. I talked about that previously, and then when it didn't work out right for chairman, I started putting out newsletters to keep people informed and involved around the state, knowing what was going on, and to be able to have an impact. And going forward, I'll continue to do that and make sure that people and all the county chairs are in touch and best practices are shared. 2 years ago, I ran for chairman when I saw the financial situation getting bad. The past great state treasurer 2 years ago endorsed me in that race because of how bad the situation was. I stood up and ran for chairman because I care about this party and want to see it grow and be stronger. That didn't work out, but then I was approached by a good activist from South Georgia, Kay Godwin, saying, hey, maybe it'd be a good idea to be in charge of the Republican Assembly and try to grow the party now. And that's what I did. We went from about six or seven paid members to over 170 with four local chapters. I've been leading a statewide grassroots organization and growing it, getting a lot of the primary volunteers from last year involved in the party process. That's what we need to be doing around the state to make sure that we continue to grow and thrive in Georgia, is to actually be expanding and growing the grassroots in Georgia. And that's what I'm committed to do. All of my contact information on the push cards, you can see the past 4 years of what I've said on advance@GOP.com, and I'd appreciate your votes in Augusta.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're at a critical point. Our state is red, but in order for it to remain red, we've got to do a lot of fundamental things. We've talked about several of them tonight. Not spending more than you bring in, being a fiscal conservative, being able to message to those donors, but also to individuals that are not with us today. When we leave that convention on June 3rd, what will we be saying to the men and women outside of the walls of that convention? Who will be able to be that visionary and that chief spokesman for this party? Who will be able to work with each of you to grow our party and to strategize into a future? Who has been with you for years, working with you at all levels of this party? When we talk about who the next chairman is going to be, we've got to look at all of the issues and not get tunnel vision on one. Because if we're going to grow and if we're going to continue to be relevant, we've got to be able to check multiple boxes. And you've got four men before you, and you've got to make that choice. I submit to you that I'm that person to work with you to do it. And I humbly ask for your support in becoming the next chairman. Not so that Michael McNeely has all the answers, but with what I bring to the table and your experience and background together, we defeat a liberal agenda on the other side of the aisle. We grow our party and we articulate a message that resonates with everyone. Thank you for your time tonight. Thank you for what you're doing in your party. God bless you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you for coming out tonight, because it's in rooms like this all across the country that make the difference. Because on June 3rd in Augusta, you will make a choice and you will choose the new state chairman. And by default, you will choose the direction of the party for the next 2 years. You are what the Founding Fathers hoped and dreamed of as electors, the electorate. You are educated. You are informed. Most importantly, you're engaged. Over the course of this campaign, I've laid out my plans. I've laid out my skills, my talents, my abilities for you to choose and decide and look at. What you'll find is that when I stand in front of you, or the governor, or the speaker, or the lieutenant governor, or the largest donor this state has, is the same person. There will be no surprises. There is a lot of transparency. I will be the same today, tomorrow, and the next day. To you, I promise that. Because together, we can make a difference. Together, we can move the party to a place it's never been before. You need an inspired leader, somebody that reaches you at the basis levels, somebody that makes you proud to be an American and a Republican. I am that person, I believe, today for this party and where we stand. And I humbly ask for your vote and your support June 3rd in Augusta, because together, we can stand tall for Georgia and turn it red. Keep it red.
Thank you, BJ, and thank you, everyone, for being here this evening. I lay my head on my pillow at night and ask for forgiveness of my sins. I wake up the next day and do the best job I can as a man and a father and a husband. The reality is, after 25 years of political involvement in the party that I love, we are indeed at a crossroads. The moment that is upon us, and the moment that each of you will discern in Augusta, must be defined by the moment that we live in, our times. We are financially broke, the state party is mismanaged, and the Democrats are on the march and are trying to achieve victory and stealing from us what we've worked so hard over the past 15 years. As you look at the candidates on this dais and at this table, understand and acknowledge that we all have strengths and weaknesses. but look at us in Augusta with where we are in this moment in time. Send someone to be the chairman who has been a professional fundraiser, who has worked his career doing the hard work on behalf of our candidates, making the tough decisions in office environments and in governor's offices where governing and people come together in many times very difficult circumstances. And send a leader to the state party that takes not one single moment of on-the-job training and is prepared to take the fight to the Democrats moment one. Thank you.